This is the Queenstown Cemetery in Queenstown, New Zealand. First burial took place here in 1866. I thought I'd take a wander. As you can see, you get good views. And it's a tourist town of Queenstown. So you get everything in the city or town. You've got gondolas, you've got boating. I've been meaning to do a walk through here again. Pretty sure last time I was here I did see someone who died on the Klondike in America, or overseas anyway, in America's. Frederick William, son of John Howe. I feel like Kingston. As you'll see, one of New Zealand's cemeteries always has great views. It's still in use. There's new and old graves. I shouldn't say cemeteries because it's already a cemetery. Frederick Augustus Ingall died in 1889. I know there's a couple of World War I people. Just a stone, Thomas Plato. You always find interesting things in a cemetery. The design of the headstones to the people themselves. From Cornwall. Died in Queenstown. And then you get something like this, so simple, you wouldn't know who it is. Wouldn't know anyone else. Matthews. Charles Eaton, Haynes. I'm going to take a walk through some of the cemetery. Here's another one. George, husband of Mary Risenler, native of Germany. Something from 1941. Henry Alexander Ricks, proprietor of the Lower Shothouse Hotel, Shotover. And you get something like this next to it. when I died in Melbourne. Christchurch in 1910. Robert Lee. And then you get this nice rock wall up the back. Don't know how old it is. Michelangelo. Not a turtle. Oh, Michelangelo, not Michelangelo. That's how you can get caught out. Nicholas Paul Balthazar von Tanzelmann. I can't actually read. Pioneers. Oops. I can't quite read that. You get little things like this. Which is unusual in itself. And that these will be the ashes. I won't linger on them. More modern part of the cemetery. Could be a bigger cemetery, but looks just right. And there is another one in town, further out of town, in an area called Frankston, which is apparently meant to be an earlier cemetery. According to the cemetery information. James Overton. Log family. It'd be who's who in the area. Oh, there's Sutherland. The bigger they have the song, you probably get more expensive and well known. And you get the crumbly thing just down further that I haven't had a look at yet. And we're back to the start. Newest modern. You get this huge one over here. I think some of them would be protected. Native of Ireland, Thomas Milligan. It's in the main thoroughfare of Queenstown. People like these as well, and the brides. And someone from Tipperary. O'Neill. Glenorchy. That Lynch. All in all, it's a cemetery that's held up. Oh, leave it here.